Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to send HTTP request from a message flow running in ACE to a backend web service, which is secured using Basic Auth. ACE version 12.0.9 provides new capability where an HTTP credential type can be dynamically updated in a vault, and the new credential is used by message flow without needing a restart of a flow or the integration server. An encrypted credential vault can be used at the integration node level or the integration server level for storing credentials. The vault uses symmetric encryption to encrypt and decrypt data records that are stored in the vault. An AES 256-bit encryption is used for encrypting the data in the vault. The vault is accessed using a vault key. So for this demonstration, I'm going to use a private integration server vault for storing an HTTP credential. I'm going to use two integration servers. One is going to be called backend and the other one will be called frontend. The backend integration server will act as a backend web service, which is secured using Basic Auth, so it requires user ID password for an API call. The frontend integration server will act as a client. And then I'll create a simple ACE message flow, deploy it to the frontend integration server, and I will send a message through the flow so that it sends the request to the backend web service using Basic Auth. So first of all, I'm going to create the integration servers. So I'll start with creating the work directory for the frontend integration server, and I'll also create it for the backend integration server. I'm just going to edit the serverconf YAML for the backend integration server so that I can enable Basic Auth. If I search for Basic, and I can uncomment this line and set the value to true so that Basic Auth will be used when the integration server is started. I'm going to set a user ID and password for accessing the integration server. I will do that using the MQSI web user admin command. I will start the backend integration server. And now I can check that the backend integration server is secured by checking if I can access the API v2 REST API. And I can see that this is asking for user ID and password. Now, in order to configure a flow where an HTTP request node is used to send an outbound message using Basic Auth, there are three things that you must do. You must create a user ID and password for the HTTP credential in the vault. You need to create a security profile policy which references the credential. And then you need to reference the security profile policy on the HTTP request node. So I'm now going to set up my vault, which the front-end integration server will use. So I'm going to run the MQSI vault command and specify the work directory that is used by the front-end integration server and a vault key. I'm now going to run a command to add a credential into the vault. So this will be a credential of type HTTP, and the name of a credential is Basic Auth Cred, and I'm specifying the admin user ID and the password for it. And I'm using the create option to indicate I want to create the credential in the vault. I'll now start the integration server for the front-end integration server. The front-end integration server is now started. So now I'm going to bring up the toolkit. And I have an empty workspace, and I'm going to create the flow and policy which is needed so that you can follow the steps. I have created the credential in the vault. I'm now going to create the policy project. I will call it basicauth_pp. Now I'll create the policy. I'm going to select the security profiles policy type. For the security profile policy, you need to set three properties in order to use Basic Auth. So the propagation field must be set to true. The identify to propagate field must contain a value static ID. And the transport propagation configuration field must contain the credential name. So I'll set the propagation field to true. I'll set the value for identifier to propagate to static ID. And if you look at the command I ran to add the credential, the name of the credential was basic auth cred. So I will set that in the policy. And I need to set that in the field transport propagation configuration. And now I can save this policy. I'll now create an application. I'll call it front end app. And I will create a flow. And I'll call it front end flow. So this will be a simple flow using HTTP nodes. So I'll start with an HTTP input node, specified path suffix. I'll add an HTTP request node. So this will send a request to the backend integration server. On the HTTP settings, I need to use a GET method. And on the security tab, I need to reference the policy that I just created. So I need to specify the policy project and the policy. I'll now add HTTP reply node. Wire it up. And I'll also add an HTTP reply node so it is connected to the error terminal of the HTTP request node so we can see any errors that come out. So I will now connect to my front-end integration server. The front-end integration server is using the admin port of 7601. So I will connect to that. So I will deploy the policy project first to the front-end integration server. And now I can put a message through the flow. I'll use the flow exerciser. I can send an empty message. And I can see I'm getting a response back. If I stop the backend server, and if I change the user ID password to access the server, so if I change it from password 1 to password 2, and then start the backend server again, if I now send another message through the flow, this time I receive an error, 401, and I can see that the username and password that is used by this flow, which is stored in the credential vault, is not matching the expected user ID password that the backend is using. So the vault currently has admin and password 1, but the backend is expecting admin and password 2. While the server is running and the flow is still running, I can update the credential in the vault by running the mqsi credentials command. And I can see that the credential has been updated with the new value of a password, which is password 2. If I return back to the toolkit, and if I send a message through the flow again, notice I have not stopped the front-end server, I've not stopped the flow. The flow is still running. I'm going to put a new message through the flow. And I can see that it has received a response back. So in this video, I've shown how an HTTP request node can send HTTP requests to a backend service using Basic Auth. I've also shown that the HTTP credentials can be updated in the vault without needing a restart of the integration server or the message flow.